Okay, let us continue with our discussion on the transpose of a matrix. We're in part 2, that is the properties of the transpose of a matrix. First property is the transpose of a matrix. So the transpose of the transpose of a matrix is equal to the original matrix. Let us have an example. Let A be the matrix with elements 3, 2, negative 1, 1, negative 3, 2. So A is a 3 by 2 matrix. So we know that the transpose of A will be a 2 by 3 matrix. Okay, so let us have the transpose of matrix A. So we have 3, 2, negative 1. So that is from the first row of matrix A. That is now the first column of the transpose of A. We have 3, 2, negative 1. Let us continue. So we'll have 1, negative 3, 2. On the second column of the transpose that is coming from the second row of matrix A. Okay, now we will now get the transpose of the transpose of matrix A. Since this is now a 2 by 3 matrix, we are expecting the transpose of this matrix will be a 3 by 2 matrix. So let us get the transpose of the transpose of matrix A. Then we have 3, 1 as the first row of the transpose. Then we will have 3, 1 on the first column of the transpose of matrix A. The next column will have 2, negative 3. That is from the second row of the transpose of matrix A. And then the last column will be negative 1, 2. So you will notice that the transpose of matrix A has the same elements as matrix A. Next property. So that is the addition property of transpose. The transpose of the sum of two matrices is equal to the sum of the transpose of the two given matrices. So that is the transpose of quantity A plus B is equal to the transpose of A plus the transpose of B. Let us say, for example, A is matrix with elements 1, negative 2, 2, negative 3. And then on the last column, 4, 1. And then matrix B has elements 2, 1 on its first column, negative 1, 3 on the second column, 1, 4 on the third column. So remember that in our previous discussion about matrices, we can only add two or more matrices when they have the same dimension. That is the number of columns and the number of rows. So let us now start by getting the sum of A and B. Getting the sum of A and B is getting the sum of the corresponding elements of matrix A and B. So we have 1 plus 2, we have 3. And then continuing on, then the sum of A and B will have 3, negative 3, 5 on the first row, and then 3, 0, 5 on the second row. Now we will get, since in our property, it is the transpose of the sum of matrices A and B, we will get the transpose of this sum. So the transpose of the sum of A and B will now be a 2 by 3 matrix. So coming from the first column of the sum of A and B, we'll have the first row of the transpose, that is 3, 3, and then negative 3, 0, and then 5, 5. Now, we will verify if this transpose of the sum is equal to the sum of the transpose of matrix A and B, or the sum of transpose of A plus transpose of B. First, let us get the transpose of A. That will be a 2 by 3 matrix with elements 1, 2 on the first row, negative 2, 3, and then 4, 1 on the last row, coming from this original matrix A. And then transpose of matrix B will have 2, 1 on the first row, negative 1, 3 on the second row, and then 1, 4 on the third row, that is coming from the original matrix B. Now, since we have the transpose of A and transpose of B, let us get the sum of these two matrices. That will be another 2 by 3 matrix. So, adding the elements correspondingly, we have 1 plus 2. That will be 3 on our resulting matrix. And then, continuing on, we'll have 3, negative 3, 0, 5, and then 5. Now, you will notice that the sum of the matrices A transpose plus B transpose is equal to the transpose of the sum of the original matrices A and B. Okay? Next property, we have the multiplication by a constant. So, the transpose of the scalar product CA is equal to the scalar product C times the transpose of A. For this one, let us have, for example, A is matrix with elements 1, 2 on the first column, negative 2, 3, and then 4, 1. So, A is a 3 by 2 matrix, and let us have the scalar as 3. So, the scalar product CA will be equal to 3, negative 6, 12, that is multiplying all the elements of the first row of matrix A by 3. And then on the second row, that is 6, negative 9, 3. Okay? And then, let us get the transpose of this scalar product. That will be a 2 by 3 matrix. So, let us start with the first row of the scalar product, that is 3, negative 6, 12. Then we will have the first column of our transpose, 3, negative 6, 12. And then the second row of the scalar product CA, 6, negative 9, 3, will be the second column of the transpose of scalar product CA, 6, negative 9, 3. Now, let us continue and check if it is the same as the scalar product C times the transpose of matrix A. Let us first get the transpose of A. That will be 1, 2 on the first row, negative 2, negative 3, and then 4, 1. Let us multiply this by the scalar 3. That will have 3, 6, negative 6, negative 9, 12, 3. So, you will notice that the transpose of the scalar product CA is the same or equal to the scalar product C times the transpose of A. Okay, let's continue. We have the multiplication property of transpose. That is, the transpose of the product AB is equal to the product of transpose of B times transpose of A. Remember that in multiplication of matrices, the commutative property does not hold. So, we follow the right-hand side in its proper order. That's transpose of B times transpose of A. And the product in the left-hand side of the equation, A times B in its proper order. Let us have A as the matrix with a square matrix with elements 1, 2 on the first column, negative 2, 3 on the second. and B be the square matrix with elements 2, 1 on the first column and negative 1, 3 on the second column. Remember that the rules for multiplying matrices applies. So if we get the product AB, we're writing matrix A, negative 1, negative 2, 2, negative 3, multiplied by matrix B. So we will start by multiplying the first row of matrix A times the first column of matrix B. That gives us sum of the products correspondingly. That gives us the first column, first row of the resulting AB. That will be 0. And then continuing on, negative 7, 1, negative 11. Then in the property, we need to get the transpose of this. So the transpose of the product AB will be given by 0, 1, negative 7, 11. That is, the rows of AB becomes the column of transpose of AB. Okay, let's continue with the left-hand side of the property, that is the product B transpose times A transpose. First, let us get A transpose from the original matrix A. That will be 1, 2, negative 2, 3. And then the transpose of B will have 2, 1, negative 1, 3. So we'll get the product, of course, having B transpose as the first factor. So we have B transpose times A transpose. And following the rules and multiplying matrices, we get 0, 1, negative 7, negative 11. You will notice that the product B transpose times A transpose is the same as the product, as the transpose of the product AB. So that is all for the properties of the transpose of a matrix. Thank you.